Hello everyone, my name is Oleg Chernyshenko. In this video, I'm going to add auto layout constraints to the UI I created in the previous video. To make the project more interesting, I want to make this app available in the landscape mode as well as in the portrait. Luckily for us, UIStackView will handle for us most of the auto layout logic. We just need to adjust the settings properly. My goal is to show the main stages of the process and make the implementation more or less similar to the images you see. I'm starting by moving the code from the WeatherView class to a separate file. Initially, I've added the view code in the same file as the view controller to make it easy to work on two files at the same time on a small screen. We need to import UI kit here. In the last video, we left with two black bars around the red background. I want to fix it by changing the pin edges method. I am copying it and changing its name to make it clear that it uses the safe area layout guy anchors. I will use it to place any UI elements that shouldn't be covered by the system UI. Let's remove the safe area layout guide part from here. I will use it for elements that should cover the screen completely and go under the status bar and the bar on the bottom of iPhone 10. Let's use a new method with the main stack. Now, when the background is pinned to the screen edges, we will not see the black bars anymore. And UI elements are staying away from the iPhone's UI. I want to show you two features that may be helpful when you are working on apps UI. To enable the first one, open the simulator and find in the menu Debug Color Blended Layers. It will show you the outlines of the visible layers. It's nice when you want to make sure that there are no overlaps and layers are sized as you expected. The second and the most useful is the debug view hierarchy mode in Xcode. It will pause the process and will show the 3D representation of the screen. You can see the hierarchy of your views and the tree view in the left panel. The name of the currently selected element is displayed on top of the screen. An important mode when you're working on the auto layout is show constraints. It will show all constraints created by you or added automatically. I will start with the top icon. I will make a new stack view by copying the main stack and renaming it to something meaningful. It's usually the hardest part for me. Let's name it condition image stack. To place the icon in the right corner, I will change the stack view's alignment to trailing. It's important to note that on a device with a left to right language, it will be placed on the left side, not right. I'm building the app to show you that the icon moved to the right. In our initial design, the city and conditions label are grouped together. To group them, I'm creating a separate stack view. I will leave it with the default values for now. I am placing the labels into the new stack view and this stack view adding to the main stack. Let's build to see that these two items were grouped. I press Command Arrow to rotate the simulator. We can see that the temperature label is centered and other labels were pushed completely out of the screen. To fix this, I need to create another stack view. Labels displayed in the center of the screen will go inside this new stack. I am leaving all the default values for now. It will contain the temperature label and the city and condition stack view. We want to place it elements horizontally when the device is rotated. To do so, I will need to use the viewWillTransition method of UIViewController. UIKit calls this method on any presented viewController whose view is about to change the size. The size property tells us the new size of the change in view. I'll use it to find if the new orientation landscape or portrait. For the landscape orientation, I want the center content stack to change the axis to horizontal. And then back to vertical for the portrait mode. Let's build to see that it works for both orientations. In the landscape mode, the distance between two labels is too big. Make sure to call the same method on the superclass. To fix the layout of the city and conditions labels, I'm going to change the distribution property of the parent stack view. UIStackView gives us 5 distribution options. We need the one that will resize its views proportionally based on the content size. You can read the detailed description of each option by out-clicking the parameter you are interested in. In portrait, all the elements are too close. In landscape, the labels are grouped, but the temperature label is cropped by the container. To increase the distance between the temperature label and the city, I am increasing the spacing. To fix the cropping, I am changing the alignment from the default fill to center. And the clipping problem is fixed. The last thing I want to fix is the positioning of the buttons on the bottom. To add some spacing next to the sides, I will add empty UI views before and after the buttons. These views will not be rendered, but will participate in the layout calculation process. I don't like that this button is visually shifted a little bit to the right. To fix this, I am changing the distribution parameter to equal centering. This layout uses not the edges of views but their centers to arrange them evenly. Much better. At this point, all our views are too close to the edges of the screen. Let's add some breathing space around. To do so, I am configuring stack views layout margins. First, I'm enabling layout margins on the view. Enabling it will tell the view to lay out its subviews relative to its margins and not the bounds as usual. Then I should specify the margins I need. It will be 30 points on every side except the top. In the portrait mode, the top already has some space due to the safe layout edges. In the landscape, it's always good to get a bit more vertical space. Let's compare the result. It's quite close. Fonts are different and some spacing is a bit off, but it all can be easily fixed with small layout manipulations. In the next video, I will connect the view to the view controller and will add some logic using the model view presenter pattern. Please like and subscribe. Cheers!